Welcome back to the Illinois Fighting Illini Dynasty. I'm your host, Jay Shoob, and we got another good one for you guys here today. It is recruiting update number one. The first recruiting update of season four is here, and we're going to get into it. After we cover the recruiting board, we're going to get into the top 25 because there is a lot of interesting nuggets to talk about there, as well as Big Ten standings, update you guys there, and then of course preview the Iowa game, which is the next game video up on the docket right after this. So let's get into it. We'll start offensively and with the quarterback position. Illinois is going after quarterbacks hard in this class. Illinois plans on taking in at least two different quarterbacks from this class. They do not want to have to face a situation like they're facing this year where only one healthy quarterback is playing at a time during a game. And we're going to start here with Wayne Johnson out of Illinois. Wayne Johnson, Illinois is expected to land him. You can see why Illinois likes him. That throw power is 87. Not the most accurate quarterback. He is 84 speed, 86 acceleration. He is a guy that is certainly a mobile scrambler quarterback, but he has a cannon of an arm, and if he can refine that accuracy, if Illinois can develop him, he's a guy that could certainly have success in the system. And he is really liking Illinois. It seems like a match made in heaven for his skill set. He's planning on visiting later on, and the Illini will likely get him. Martin Ellison, he is a totally different caliber of player. He is a pocket passing quarterback. He's a three-star rated recruit. Illinois has not given a scholarship offer yet. You can see we have not been able to scout him because he was not part of our original recruiting board. And again, he has that strong throw power. The accuracy is not the greatest according to the advanced scouting, but Illinois has not offered him yet. And Illinois may not end up offering at all. It depends how these other quarterbacks play out with their commitments. Shane Oliver, a three-star out of Winter Springs, Florida. He's a guy out of Florida that Illinois really wants to retain as a pipeline state in the near future. Again, same ratings. His throw power has a B grade. His throw accuracy is a C grade. And potentially Shane Oliver is a guy that Illinois can maybe redshirt, develop down the road. Not a guy that maybe Illinois would figure would start anytime soon, but a guy that Illinois can at least have as depth at the quarterback position. And Illinois is his only offer, and it looks like he is definitely going to commit. It's a matter of when, not if. Now moving over to the fullback position, we already covered Charlie Young's commitment. He's a number six fullback in the class. He's a blocking fullback, and we need one on the roster, so that'll be Charlie Young to take starting next year. And then moving over to tight end, Illinois is looking to take on one tight end. They only have two on the roster right now. Ricky Ernst, a four-star out of Wycliffe, Ohio, is Illinois' top target at this position. He is the number 15th ranked tight end in this recruiting class. He doesn't particularly stand out in any area, but he's very solid across the board and definitely a guy that wouldn't start right away if he were to commit to Illinois, but a guy that could potentially see the field down the road. And as of right now, it looks like it's a two-horse race between the Illini and Notre Dame. Ernst already visited Notre Dame a couple weeks ago, and Illinois is still ahead, so that's a good sign. And then Nathan Kelly, very briefly, Kelly is sort of like a backup option if Ernst does not commit. He is out of Louisiana. He has a very low scouting grade. Illinois has not been able to scout him yet. And again, he is just sort of backup in case Ernst does not commit. You can see he's favoring Louisiana Tech, Wisconsin, UCLA, some other small schools there. And now moving on to Trey Tyson. Yes, Tyson is a five-star tackle out of Okeechobee, Florida. The number ranked tackle in this recruiting cycle, and Illinois is on his list. This has been a dogfight in the recruiting game all cycle long. Look at the blocking grades there for Trey Tyson. He was added to the original recruiting board in the preseason. 85 pass block, 84 run block, 85 impact blocking. He's got 92 acceleration, 86 strength. He is a legit NFL caliber prospect. He can start day one. And Illinois has been going very hard after him all season long. You can see he is in a battle. He is favoring five different schools: Boston College, Toledo, Penn State, even Vanderbilt is on his list. He already visited Toledo, and he's still going to visit all of these schools I just mentioned back to back to back to back. So Illinois is sort of bunched in there. And I'm really hoping that the Illini can land Tyson. He would be a guy that could potentially play right away, but we shall see. That's going to be a fun battle to watch. Brandon Pennington now moving over to the center position. Pennington is a four-star center prospect out of Michigan. You can see his blocking grades there, very solid across the board. Maybe not necessarily a four-star caliber player based on his grades, but still a guy out of the state of Michigan that Illinois wants to bring in and just add depth to this position along the offensive line. And as of right now, Illinois is the big front runner to land Pennington. So if Illinois can keep getting players to commit that are from the state of Michigan, that would really help in adding Michigan as a pipeline state. And that's something that Illinois really wants moving forward here, to keep the faucet running out of the state of Michigan. It has been a very lucrative state as far as recruiting talent, and Illinois wants to establish themselves in that state. Next up is Kevin McCray moving over to the defensive side of the ball. McCray, he committed at the beginning of the year. He was our first overall commit, another prospect out of Florida, the number four ranked defensive end in this class. He's a four-star prospect. He is a guy that could potentially play early in his career. And now moving over to defensive tackle. This is a position where Illinois is going very hard this year. They need to take on two, possibly even three players from this class. They already have a commit, but with two seniors graduating and Jerzon Newton and Trevon Riggins, Illinois needs to bring in a handful of these boys here at the defensive tackle position, starting with Marcus Dixon. He was added to the board midseason, and so far Illinois has had a ton of success with Dixon. We are his only offer, and it looks like he will more likely than not commit. We just haven't been able to scout him yet. Bryce Smith, a home state kid out of Bartlett, Illinois. He's a number 52 ranked defensive tackle in this class. He is known best for his run stopping ability, but Bryce Smith, he was part of our original recruiting board in the preseason. We were able to scout him, and he is a gem prospect. Look at the power moves, 81 grade power moves there for Bryce Smith. Illinois would be very happy to land him, but he has two other offers besides Illinois. Northwestern and Wisconsin are also in the mix for him. He has already visited Illinois, so that's what's giving the Illini a big lead here. So that'll be another interesting battle to watch. Billy Anderson, next up. Anderson, he is a guy that is considered a depth piece for this position. Illinois has been able to scout him. Very solid grades across the board, nothing that stands out per se. But Anderson is a guy that Illinois can bring on. He will more likely than not commit. We are his only offer. He wants to come to Illinois, and he's a guy that will certainly be redshirted and maybe play later on in his career. And then James Henderson, the top target at this position, we already got him to commit. Henderson most likely will not be redshirted next year. He will be able to play as a true freshman, so I'm very excited to see Henderson. He's a recruit out of Missouri, and he's certainly a guy that Illinois is happy to bring in. Now moving over to linebacker and outside linebacker, Mike Jenkins out of Indiana. Mike Jenkins, he's a very good coverage linebacker, and Illinois brought in a lot of good young linebackers in last year's class, so they do have a good amount of depth at this position, and they're not necessarily jumping at the gun to add more linebackers this cycle, but Mike Jenkins, it's not the end of the world if Illinois does not land him. However, they are still sort of mildly pursuing him, and we'll see what goes on with Jenkins. At middle linebacker, Paul Burke, a four-star player, again out of Michigan. Paul Burke is a guy that Illinois is interested in. Again, similar to Mike Jenkins, they are not necessarily pursuing him super hard, but you can see the block shedding grades there are very solid. His tackling grades are solid, just an overall very solid across the board linebacker prospect, and it's a three-horse race between the Illini, Kentucky, and UNC. He is favoring Kentucky despite the fact that they haven't offered him yet, so we'll see how that plays out. And now moving over to corner. There's a handful of corners Illinois is looking to take in. They already got one. They are taking in one more, potentially two more. We'll start with Eric Wade out of Texas. Eric Wade is a guy that was added to the original recruiting board. He's a very good coverage corner. 79 man coverage, 82 zone coverage. That is his strength. And he's a guy that Illinois could certainly see excel in this system. A guy that Illinois is also trying to win out a battle against Iowa with. Iowa's already offered him as well, so we'll see how that one goes. That's been neck and neck all cycle long. And now Joe Thompson out of Illinois. As of right now, Illinois is his only offer, and Illinois is sort of considering him as a depth piece. He was added to the board midseason, so we haven't been able to scout him. And again, he's sort of considered backup or a depth piece at this position, and Illinois just wants to stack up on young talent at corner and potentially maybe move these guys to safety later on in their careers. Next up is James Johnson, very similar to Joe Thompson. James Johnson, a lot of word scrambling there with their names very similar. He is a Michigan player. That's another guy out of the state of Michigan. You've seen the strategy here. Illinois wants to establish Michigan as a pipeline state in the future. Illinois is his top school. We are his only offer besides NIU, and it looks like he will more than likely commit. So Johnson and Thompson are both depth pieces for this position to complement Jeff Garcia, who we've already gotten to commit. He is by far the top target at this position. He's out of South Carolina. He is a gem prospect, three-star recruit, and Illinois is very happy to have him on board here. And then moving over to punter, we already covered Larry Gibson committing on the other video. Gibson is our punter of the future starting next year, and we are excited about that. And lastly, the athletes are very important in this class, and Illinois has a couple that they are pursuing, one that is committed, starting off with Brock Bell is an in-state kid out of Illinois, and you can see his scouting grades here. He was a gem prospect. Bell is a guy that can play quarterback, running back, or receiver, and you can see his throw power there. He's got a cannon for an arm. His accuracy is still very decent. His elusiveness, juke move, injury, acceleration grade are very solid. He is certainly a guy that I believe Illinois could potentially play at quarterback, but his position assignment will depend on how the rest of the class shapes up, as you guys will see here in a second. And as of right now, we are his only offer, his only scheduled visit. He will be an Illini. It's just a matter of when, not if. Blake Moyer, a five-star player out of the state of Mississippi. Moyer has been on Illinois' recruiting board from the jump. Look at his throw power and throw accuracy there at the bottom. It is very rarely that you find a high school recruit that has 83 grade accuracy, 86 grade speed, 91 acceleration. Moyer is a guy that could play quarterback, defensive back, or even wide receiver if he wanted to. And the plan is, if he commits to Illinois, the Illini would turn him into a quarterback. They really like Moyer's skill set, and they could envision him absolutely thriving in this system with that throw power, throw accuracy, and speed grade, all of that combined into one. He could be a phenomenal player in our spread system. And Illinois is in a hard-fought battle right now with Mississippi State. The Illini are trying to pry him out of his home state, and as of right now, it appears it's a two-horse race between the Illini and Mississippi State. Southern Miss is also in the mix, but it looks more likely than not it'll be between the Illini and the Bulldogs. This race has been tight all season long. Illinois has put in the max amount of recruiting resources in order to get Blake Moyer, and if he commits, that would be a very big deal. And lastly, Joe Edmonds. He already committed a couple videos ago. He's a four-star recruit out of Pekin, Illinois, and he's another guy that we were able to scout early on. He has that 90 grade speed. We were very excited about him. So that'll do it for the recruiting class. Looking at the pipeline states here, you can kind of see the strategy for why Illinois was doing what they were doing with the geography of where they were recruiting and targeting their recruits. Of course, Illinois is a pipeline state. They are projected to lose Missouri next year. Not a big deal. Illinois wants to keep Florida as a pipeline state. I've sort of neglected that in the previous cycles. So now with my own new recruiting house rules, I'm going to try to focus on reviving Florida as a pipeline state. I'm punting away Texas, unfortunately, but we are trying to add Michigan and keep Michigan as a pipeline state. I've been surprised how many good recruits have come out of the state of Michigan. And as far as the rankings so far, it is still mid-season right now, but Illinois has the 24th ranked class, and I expect that to only get better as the season goes on and more commits come through. And now looking at the top 25, Nebraska is number one in the country. They are undefeated along with UNC and Illinois at the top of the rankings. And this Nebraska game is looming. I cannot wait for that. We're going to get to that here in just a second. You can see Nebraska's schedule. They scraped one out against a very bad Nevada team at the beginning of the year, but then they got on a roll. They have a good win at Michigan in the Big House, who the Illini have already played. So Nebraska not necessarily blowing everyone out of the water per se, but also looking very solid, very dominant. There's a reason they're ranked number one this year. And then North Carolina out of the ACC, UNC also is undefeated. They scraped one out first week of the year against Purdue and then have handled the rest of their opponents. They have a nice looking win at home against the number 10th ranked Georgia Tech. So that's a good win on their resume. So UNC one spot ahead of the Illini. And there we are at number three in the country. This is the highest ranking we've ever received in this dynasty. Number three in the country. And you can see the Illini schedule. It looks very good. Their resume looks very good right now after beating the number five ranked Notre Dame team, who has not lost since that game, and also picking up a win against Michigan, who's ranked number 13. In my opinion, Illinois has the best resume of any team in the country, and they have a very strong case to be ranked number one. But with that being said, LSU is also in the mix. They have one loss. They lost to Vanderbilt of all teams at the beginning of the year, but they have a good win against Texas and Oklahoma. Also beat number 7th ranked Texas A&M, so LSU has a handful of top 25 wins along with their loss there. And then there's Notre Dame. That win for us at the beginning of the year is looking very, very good. Notre Dame is ranked number 5 in the country. And like I said, you can make strong argument that Illinois should be ranked number 1 in the country based off of their resume. But the good news is we'll be able to settle that on the field because the Illini will face off against Nebraska here in a couple weeks. And looking at these Big Ten standings so far, the only two undefeated teams in conference play are those two teams. Wisconsin is also in the mix. Wisconsin has yet to play Illinois or Nebraska, so you cannot count the Badgers out. They have also been good in this dynasty consistently. And then over to the East, it is same old, same old. It seems like this division never changes in this dynasty. This division has been a mess. These teams always beat up on one another. And so far, early on, it looks like Michigan, who was our cross-divisional opponent this year, they look like the front-runner to win the Big Ten East, but who knows what's going to happen there. So now, moving on to the Iowa preview. Hope you guys have enjoyed the content so far. Let's get to this Iowa game. Iowa comes into Champaign. It's another home game for Illinois. It seems like we've had a lot of home games so far this season. And Iowa is going to be ranked number 24. They are coming off a loss last week to Purdue, but Iowa is 6-2 overall on the season. They have a good record, and this is an offense that has put up points. They are number 19 in the country in points per game. They have the number 8 ranked passing offense in the entire country. So it's a very big contrast of styles, a very big contrast of Iowa's offense in real life. But with that being said, Deuce Hogan, their quarterback, I mean, look at the ratios there. 22 touchdown passes and only one interception. We're only halfway through the season here. He's thrown for over 1,500 yards. That is absolutely insane. I haven't seen a quarterback put up those numbers in his dynasty so far like Hogan has. And looking at their receiving, of course, when you have numbers like that, guys like Deontay Vines have ridiculous numbers, like 12 touchdown receptions on the year. Looking at Iowa's schedule here, you could see they got a solid win on the road against Iowa State. They beat Ohio State, they beat Indiana, Purdue, and then they lost their last two games. They lost a close game at Wisconsin by 4 points, and then they got blown out of the water at home by Northwestern, who's only 2-6, which is a very odd result. But either way, I think Illinois will have their radar up for this team. It is still a good team that can put points up on the board. And looking at Iowa's roster, they do have some good players. They have a lot of seniors on this team. Luke Lakey, Elijah Yelverton are two very good tight ends. This is an Iowa team that could put up points. Is always known for having a very solid offensive line as well. And we'll see how it goes. I'm very interested to see this matchup and for this Illini secondary to get tested this week. But I was holding off on showing you guys this. Deuce Hogan is out for 6 weeks. He suffered a foot fracture last week against Northwestern, which makes sense why Iowa got blown out by Northwestern. They lost their best quarterback, who has been lighting it up this year. And Charles Lemon, the backup, will be the quarterback moving forward for Iowa. So Illinois catches a huge break by not having to go up against Hogan. And this is an Iowa offense that will likely struggle with a fifth-year senior quarterback that's not the highest-graded guy and doesn't have a lot of experience. So Illinois catches a huge break without having to face Deuce Hogan. They will face Charles Lemon in this Iowa offense that still has a very talented set of receivers and tight ends, but Illinois will try to not look ahead. Illinois will still not face as tough of a test as they would if Hogan was playing. And with all that being said, it is also dangerous territory for the Illini. Despite the fact that Illinois has owned Iowa in this series, Coach Deal is 3-0 against Iowa so far in this dynasty. We have not lost the Hawkeyes yet, but that Nebraska game is looming next week, and you know how big of a game that's going to be. Nebraska's ranked number one, we just saw that, and Illinois does not want to get caught looking ahead to that Nebraska game. Coach Deal will make sure of that, so all the focus and attention is on Iowa, and the Illini will be prepared and ready to go. I don't have any doubts about that. Hope you guys have enjoyed this video here today. It was much needed to get caught up on the recruiting. Let me know what your favorite recruiting prospect is from this class in the comments. And I will see you guys for the next video as the Illini hosts Iowa. Thank you and have a great day.